Huh. Welcome to Forever, man. Let's go. This is Forever. No surrender. Yeah. You know that this right here forever. Go. Now allow me to reintroduce myself, they call me J-O, N to the easy E-N. Know that we undefeated, y'all are beneath them speechless trying to air a grievance. But his lines are overhead, better check the air for clearance. Call the tower, this is ours, clear the heat of air apparent. Really, I've never been better. Legacy, this is forever. All the more times I've been severed, I'm raising the bar, you can go ahead and...
J-Shrek, I'll tell you what, we are on another adventure today. It's been a while since we've been back out in Arizona. And you know, one of the cool things about Arizona is you don't know what kind of weather you're gonna get. Take a look at what we got today. Now, one thing that we've been looking at is we wanted to go back to a location that was hit by fire. And normally what's neat about Arizona is they actually have archaeologists that work with the hotshot companies that try to save and make sure that we preserve these areas that that have ruins. And I hate to tell you that I'm very disappointed that that didn't happen. And you know, again, when you look at secret locations, we're at what I call the Facebook ruins, which is Arrastre Creek, which I believe is Spanish for basically a term for mining. And it did not get saved. Now, a lot of people might say, well, you know, really, it's rock, right? But the problem is these areas are very susceptible to erosion once there's no vegetation holding the mountainsides in. So that's where you're really kind of getting the problem. So I wanted to come down here and take a look at this area to see how well it had been preserved. Now, this is a very special location. I personally believe that, you know, people have been coming here, you know, for thousands of years, not hundreds, but thousands. I believe this is a very ancient site that continues to be repurposed. And if you look around, here is what I believe to be one of the sheep herders' foundations right here, AKA or cattle, right in this area right here. And then if you look back over here, you start to see what I would believe is the pens. And these walls are really spectacular. These are some of the nicest walls that you're going to see anywhere. And they were built on a location that the ancients had been using for the same purpose. And you know, so why is that important? Is because, you know, a good area is a good area. It was a good area a thousand years ago. It's a great area today. Why? Because it has water. And this is the desert. So guess what? Now, if you look along these walls right here, and this was almost like a channel right here, you can tell this double wall where they would have herded the animals through here. It's a very incredible place. I mean, if you go up here and you look at this, it's a very spectacular place. And then you have more modern here, but then when you slip over here, you get into ancient. Now, this pin down here is absolutely phenomenal, and it's sad that we did not save it. It does look like some of the animals have come back, but we did not save this. Now, one of the areas that I really think is neat is where they kind of interchanged the modern with the ancient. Just saw an animal go right in there, in that hole right there. I don't know what it was. But let's get up in here and see what... There's a rock I want to show you guys that really is pretty spectacular. You can tell this rock has had a lot of wear right here. Look at that. that rock's been worked for a long time. So if you get up in here and you see this, look at that. They've set up on this rock, up on this mound for a long, long time. Now look at the wall down below. And those are petroglyphs over there, but they worked all this area here, all the way through here. But I tell you what, this is really a spectacular place, like I said, because you have the evolution of this hillside in the different cultures that were here. And you look through here as you're walking across and you see petroglyphs as well as then more modern sheep herder walls, which are probably late 1800s, early 1900s. They use the same area. It's really sad to see this, like I'm in the state I'm seeing it, because normally what happens is the hotshots have archaeologists that know where these areas are located at. So if they have an area that needs to be saved, I've not seen one burnt like this before, and it's really sad that it didn't get saved. You know, the fire might have started. What's sad is you see the fire line over there. The problem is that all the ruins are here. So, you know, when all these people talk about, oh, keep it secret, well, this is what sometimes secret gets. And that doesn't mean that this couldn't have not been saved. But, you know, if people don't know where they're at, well, guess what? Then when catastrophes happen, they can't save them. So it's kind of sad. Is. And again, it's not, you know, it's rock, but the problem is that vegetation is not holding the water back. So when the water comes through here and it rains, which it looks like it's getting ready to do right through here. Now, one thing I do believe that is that there are different levels of ancients, and this is the old ancients. This is way back. So this is before they built stone structures, and it is an incredible place. We're going to go to an area where is waterfalls down here, and there's some awesome stuff. So we're going to work our way down. One thing is that there's not a bunch of vegetation that we're having to trace through. And it is nice to see that the rabbits have come back. We're still on an area we call basically the Perry Mesa. I mean, this entire area, there was ancients all through here. And then as the time evolved forward, mining, now those would be the Bradshaw Mountains over here. And one thing that most people don't realize is the amount of Chinese workers that was in this area. Now, in California, the prejudice in California with the Chinese was pretty heavy. But here, we needed workers so bad, they actually treated them better. So they got a lot more respect in this area. And they had a lot to do with the Black Canyon area. Now, these walls, I tell you, I do love these walls. Again, I'm a little disappointed in the quality of the... Because it was just right there. I mean, we're only 50 yards, 60 yards from being able to save this. But there is a little green starting to pop up, it looks like, which is promising. Hopefully it gets up before we lose this wall. We're in the Arrastre Creek. Now look at the quality of that wall right there. Tell me that isn't unbelievable. So look at this wall that comes up the hill. This would have been some type of pin down here. Goes all the way up there, then all the way through here. How incredible is that? Now I'm real curious to see, because I know I had a lot of petroglyphs over in this area over here. I've walked this before. So I'd be real curious to see, you know, what kind of toll it took. There was a major kitchen over here in this area somewhere, and we'll find it again as we walk through here. You know, it's great to be back out here today. It's great to, be out in the Arizona wilderness up on this mesa. a little, again, disappointing. But you know, a lot of times these fires can be caused by lightning. I mean, the ancients dealt with this, natural disasters as well. So we just hope that the desert heals itself. But you always hope places like this get saved. There's a few tracks. We've had a few people through here, it looks like, but we don't get a lot of people over in this area. We're gonna work our way down this ridge line to see. You know, I tell you what, let's take a look over there, because I know we had some stuff over there. We had some petroglyphs, and we've got some really, really old petroglyphs in this area. But hopefully down the creek, we didn't deal with the fire. Take a look from over here and see those extremely, those are extremely impressive walls. Look how nice that wall is right there. That is pretty unbelievable. And you know, the quality workmanship lasted the test of time for sure. Tell you what, these rocks here look worked to some degree. Let me take a look at this right here. We've got a kitchen right there we can see. Now we can look up over here. You know, you see these stones. I don't know if this is a stone that was meant to be in this location, but you see that, and it's just, it really is cool. And then you look over here, and you don't know if somebody else just added that stone to it or not, but you look at this right here. Yeah, they could, I mean, definitely get in the middle of an ancient kitchen, because if we walk over here, and then there's a petroglyph right here. Now I've walked these, and we'll walk this area on the way out of here. But here are some petroglyphs right here. That's a nice rock right there, actually. So if you look through here, you're gonna see all kinds of stuff. Kind of sad down there. You know, I don't know what kind of effect, you know, the fire is going to have on any of this stuff. Now, a lot of the petroglyphs are like this one right here. They've been grooved in. They've actually been really grooved in these rocks pretty deep. It's really a pretty spectacular place to be. Ow, that hurt. And this rock here looks like it's got some work on it right here. But if you can see across here, you can see the amount of burn through here. There's a kitchen right here. It does look like somebody's been walking through here. And there is a very nice petroglyph right here. There's a place where they've been, right there, been grinding. But look at this one. Now that's a really a good guy right here. This is a pretty impressive area, right? This location right here, right there. So again, here's the ancient man, and here's the not so ancient man. We're gonna do is we're gonna work our way down the stream. You know, some of the vegetation's starting to grow back. It's gonna be a slow process though. But if you do get water in Arizona, as they used to say, you can grow hair on a cue ball with enough water. So let's take a look and see what's over here. one of the cool little areas that see this little worked out area right here. Definitely looks like an area that was used for some type of maybe gathering location right here. And then when you get up here, you also see this petroglyph right here on these rocks. So they were here, then you can see them up there and then over there. So this definitely was a location that they were actively working. There's pieces in this rock right here as well. But they've got almost like a level of layers, just like this up here. You get up here and you just get a feel that you're dealing with a pretty, you got an animal hole right there. You're dealing with a pretty special location. Kind of just get that feel. Another dugout, another man right on that rock right there. So they would have been working this whole side, but spent a lot of time down here grinding. And pretty spectacular place. You see a lot of grooved rocks. At first you're like, well, that's not, yeah. And then you look at it hard enough, you can tell that that definitely was worked. This whole amphitheater type area is pretty incredible. It really is. As you walk through here, you work our way down to what they call the waterfall.
But adjoining it is others that are almost impossible.
Oh my God, this is loaded.
Loaded?
You guys want to... There's grooves right there. And that panel was really good last time we saw it. Last time I shot it, you could see it a lot better.
The damn thing is old. That's an old panel.
Well, it's full of stuff over here. See that?
Yeah, all the way down.
More spot?
Yeah, over here. All the way through.
And then, you can't see it. But
now look at this piece right up there. Isn't that neat? Now last time we were here, it really popped a lot harder. But if you'll notice, there's a nice panel right there that I was going to get over to. But that's a little hairy right through there. And then there's a circle down below, which then means there's others around. It's just a matter of getting down there and taking a look. And so what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna go up this ridge a little bit just to see what's up there, because if they were down here, they were definitely working up there. There's no doubt they were working up there. So now last time we were here also, this Tinajas was really a deep pool and it was full of water. I guess it wasn't super deep, but 2 or 3 feet. It was all the way up last time we were here. And I love the lines on those rocks from the water. So we're gonna work our way up here just to see if there's anything that last time we were up here we missed. But we're gonna work our way over that way and see what's up there. There's stuff right here. Look at that. Again, this is super old stuff. You can tell just by the wear on it. Super old. We're gonna get up here. Take a look. See if there's anything up on this ridge. I'm not sure last time I was here that I went down there, but there's what you got. Check across this way. See if there's anything over there. And go from there. This is where you don't want to get any oh shit rocks going on. Definitely. Look how cool that is. That is beautiful. See, there's not a real easy way to get down there that I can see. You know, maybe running this ridge line down and over there. But there's not a lot of easy ways down. It's going to be a pretty strenuous hike. But it is what it is. Listen to that quiet. And then, okay, now, if you look over there, that's stuff we didn't see before. We didn't see any of that work right there on that wall. We saw the little animal, but we didn't see the panel behind it. You know, they would have had a fairly easy way to get down in here. And I'm not sure exactly what that was, but they were also born here, most likely. Some of them, at least. So then there's a panel down there. So it's kind of funny, just like John was saying, on one side you see one thing and on the other you see another. That's a nice panel down there. Oh man, there's a big panel down there. So there definitely is work all along these walls that you got to go to both sides to get to. But they were definitely down in here, so there's probably more work on these walls. Now there's work over there on that wall too. So they were working all this throughout here. Gonna try to get over here and sit down for a second, just take a look, see what's over here. So they were working all along this ridge line through here, but boy, they didn't, from this angle, does not look like there's an easy way down. Now somewhere down in there, now 17 would be down there, but somewhere down there also is a windmill. So I'd definitely like to get down and see those panels here, for sure. And then see what else is kind of hidden. Looks like there's two levels. Hell, there's a petroglyph down there in the bottom in between those rocks. So there's stuff everywhere in here. Now, that's not the way to go where John's at, definitely. Maybe shooting across these rocks here might work. But I guarantee you what I'm going to need to do is I'm going to need to find that over here before I try to get, because we're not going that way unless you go way down. So that doesn't look feasible there. Well, this is going to be pretty exciting, I think. I didn't really expect it to be exciting today, to be honest with you, other than it's going to be a lot of fun getting back out here and getting after it. But it's going to be an intriguing journey down that hill if that's what we decide to do. So we'll figure it out, but it's pretty rare. So let's see if we can't figure our way down here. So what we're trying to do is figure out the best safe pass. You see what I'm seeing right here. It ain't coming down this wall for sure. Wow, look at that little cross, that little man. That little bitty, it's about that big. He's right there. That's incredible. If that's what that actually is. But I'd like to get over there. There is not a ton of places that, even when you get to that level there, that's gonna be, you know, look at all these down here. You know, every once in a while you pop into one throughout here. And then try to figure out, these definitely appear to be extremely old. But trying to find a path and a walkway to get down there is going to be, it's gonna be interesting. So let's get back over here and see. I think we're done on this side as far as what we can do to get done. Let's take a walk on the wild side. As we come through here, I'll take a look and see if there's anything, any way to get across here. Hate to have rocks do that on you. I don't see any safe way to get down through there. Ancients were all over here, though. There's no doubt. They were climbing all over these walls. This was a major work area down here. Now, once you get down here, what you notice is all of a sudden these petroglyphs start popping. Now, at first, I only saw this piece right there, and then all of a sudden, there's a section right there, there's a section right there. This right here has been worked right there. There's a man right there that I didn't even see before. So you can see by the, oh, look at that. Now, see that, I did not even see that. Look at this right there. Look at that. Now, they also grooved that out. So once you really start looking at this thing, you start realizing that there's stuff everywhere. And there's more stuff right there that I didn't see before. All I got to do is figure out, okay, what's the safe way to get down there to kind of actually look at that. It looks like climbing, but it doesn't look too bad if I come across these rocks down this area right here and then down and then over. But all of a sudden, I'm starting to see hundreds of petroglyphs that I did not see before, and they are old. That thing there is pretty unique and pretty old. So is these grooves in this rock right here. Now, I didn't even see those before, but if you look at these rocks right here, these have all been worn. So all these rocks have been really walked on. So there was a major amount of traffic and stuff going on right here in this specific work area, you know, where the waterfall would have been. And then on down there, you also notice that there's work all about that. Again, that's a spectacular panel. That would be a great panel to be able to de-stretch because that is pretty unbelievable. But you look at all these rocks and you can see that they're worn. Now, some of this could have been water through here, but a lot of this is not. This is human wear. Look how incredible that is. Let's work our way on up this hill right here. Let's see if we can't find a good place to get down in this area down there. And at least say we got down there. That wall there looks worked as well. That's a little harder to see, but that looks like some type of working right there.